Hello everyone, welcome to the Just Real podcast, and today's guests are none other than Mick and Kennedy, Scousers in a van. I hope you enjoy. Peace, love and light.
It's all about relaxing.
It's funny, you know.
I said to him, I went, like, this time, like, a few years ago, or even last year, we should have taught you to be in fucking Halloween.
This is podcast material.
Yeah, Halloween, in a fucking cemetery, eating crickets.
In a van.
With me.
Man, a bend in
it. Oh, yeah, I'm a fucking, let me tell you now, my life was a lot different 3 years ago from what I'm doing right now.
Yeah.
Fucking hell, I'd have been fucking dressed as a little bunny in a fucking party, fucking like, hey, and all that. And I go, what's a podcast? What's a van? Like a van life, what's that?
It's just all about fucking chilling, innit? Yeah. But Mick was saying that before about fucking when he met you, Ken, fucking you were, like, you weren't into the nature and all that sort of stuff.
It wasn't that I wasn't into it, it's just, you can't be into something that you don't know, you know what I mean?
I know what you mean, but
I had never really went out or anything like that, so.
He told me the best story about how you met. How was that again? How
in the gay bar.
Hey! Oh, well, that's all about
okay,
it.
Okay, so my story's different to Kennedy's story, innit?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I had a lot of alcohol around the table, that's why she come over to me, approach me.
Yeah.
But here's his difference, here's his, oh, he's not gay, he's quite fit, so.
Yeah, all my mates are gay, and like, we were just going off and stuff, and like, no, I didn't want to meet anyone, but because I was going to gay bars,
neither did I.
There was no one there for me, and all my gay mates are all like, you know, cracking on and all that, and I went, oh, hang on, like, been going the same club for fucking months and months, and I went, he's not gay, he's a bit of me, so can I put my drink on your table? But he thinks I come over because there was drinks on the table.
Thought I had a bit of dollar, that's what it was, I'm telling you.
And then he's on the helicopter, we ended up in Stanley Park.
What's the helicopter?
Jumping to show you.
Go on.
Helicopter, yeah. Literally, I'm known for it. I've got a lot of gay mates. My brother's gay, Tommy. My best mate's gay, Ryan. And I'm known for it in the gay bars. Before Scousers in a van, it was OMG. Mick, straight lad, pants down. Helicopter. So we get the birds.
Well, listen, I think gay people are fucking like the best fucking mates sometimes, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's But anyway, our story was. So my mate Ryan, from Poole, I think you know Ryan, yeah?
I know who you're talking about.
Yeah, it's...
I've seen him, I'm crap with face.
Yeah, he just looks gay.
I think I remember that one. Vaguely, yeah.
Yeah, well Ryan, he's one of my best mates in the world, I love him and that, and he wanted to go out, have a good night, he wanted to go in the pool, basically, yeah, fucking...
So was you his wingman?
Yeah. But it's mad because Kennedy was... Lewis's wingman, weren't you?
Yeah, so wingman and two gay people.
Wingmen,
now these
fucking
now these
wingmen
gay ones, two gay people, these two gay ones cracked on that night, and the both of them are like, ooh, couldn't think. Do you know what I mean? Because now they know each other, they're both two complete opposites.
Yeah, they're mates,
but they're like, whoa, like.
But it was Kennedy sort of come over doing a little jig. She's going.
We've got pictures.
Put a bottle on our table.
We've got pictures of the first day we met. Do you know, like, have you ever been in a nightclub and you're absolutely bladders and they do this big flash on you and you go dead white and you're like that?
Yeah.
Well, we've got them pictures the first time you met. So.
She shorts on this little jiggy pop, like, whoa. Like, and put up
there. Yeah,
very much. Very much.
Right.
I was flirting with all
my
gays.
Oh,
I was all over the gays.
Yeah,
listen, you'd have a belt of night out in them gay bars and all that. Yeah. A belt of night out in them.
Yeah.
But there's some straight people go to the gay bars, don't they, sometimes? For this reason.
I think gay bar isn't even a... It may as well be a straight bar, because that's where they all go. The lads.
Then, obviously, you have met there. Did you go on a date, or was it just straight out into the wild?
We ended up in Stanley Park, pushing around on the swing at like 5 a.m. Yes. About 7 a.m, where are people going to work?
I swear there was no drugs involved, and we were rolling around. 9 a.m, on the swings, going wee!
Yeah, swinging around, and she come to mine, where I live now, well, where I lived, and I couldn't get rid of it. I couldn't get rid of it for 3 days. And then I finally took her home, like, oh, geez, I'm Scotty, oh, bloody hell. You know what I mean? And then she went, I don't want nothing serious. She went, neither do I.
And he was like, oh, yeah, that's perfect. So we can just be like, you know.
We can just be, you know, friends. Yeah. And then
we were denied, what was it,
been able to get rid of us since.
We were just trying to like deny the fact that like, wow, we really are like clicking here. Like we were like, we don't want it serious. And then in the end, like a few months down the line, I was like, listen, Mick, what's going on here?
What do you mean, what's going on here?
Like, I didn't think I was going to meet someone like you.
But that sort of first bit of like event, like if you're on a swing on the first sort of, not even a date, it's just going to the park with your birds, with someone you're gibbing. Yeah. Or
7 in the morning.
if you're doing that, it's obviously going to go somewhere.
Yeah, of course. It was good. And then Kennedy didn't, she always says to me, I didn't know relationships was like that. I'm like what? Like your best mate, you can have a laugh and all that. So, it's all serious, people are like, yeah, I know.
It's a special one, isn't it?
Yeah, it's I mean, everyone says we're twin flames, don't they? Our souls have danced in the past and stuff like that. And it's weird though, because we get people saying it's mad how we're both the same.
The best relationships, I think, have got to be friendships. And the big thing as well is like jealousy. You can sit there and go, she's a nice looking girl, like on a film or anything, just like that. Like, it's normal.
Or can be like, Ken, look at this fit bit. Here, isn't she fit?
You can't go too far.
And then Ken's like, right, that's it. And then she gets her bikini on. Go hey, and look at me and all. So I do that for the reason.
You can't have no jealousy. Yeah. You've just got to be like. Yeah.
Listen, jealousy is one of them things, isn't it? But as you say, if you're friends and all that, that's the way, isn't it? That's how you got to start. And a bit when you said before, Ken, that you sort of didn't really form a relationship until like ages after you've met. You're building friendship up. That's the most important part.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
People say.
You made me wait, like, didn't you? And he asked me to. He went to bed.
You're a lot prettier than me. How can I make you wait?
You made me, because I'm not going to ask you.
Went to Benidorm and I am my gay mate again.
And that's where he asked me to be his girlfriend. So he goes to Benidorm.
I was off my tits on Gary's, by the way.
And he goes to, I was on Kurt. And he said, and we were on the phone to each other. And he went, will you be my girlfriend?
I can't remember.
But I thought he was going on this holiday.
I still think we're friends.
He was going on this holiday, a single man. So I thought, like, you know, he was going to, like, you know, do the helicopter and all that.
Well,
obviously he must have realised, you know, what's it called, the Harcrows Fonda. Yeah, so there's me like, oh, what's going on holiday? We've only been seeing each other for 3 months, but we're not boyfriends.
And there's me on the phone like that.
Yeah, my girlfriend.
On the garage.
And then his mate told me he didn't stop talking about me,
so. Yeah, so obviously he made an impression. Yeah. But when he said there, then what were you on? Garage's. I thought she was going to go, meh. And then she was like, I'm on Cat. As well.
Honestly,
we don't even take drugs, it's the mad thing. It's just one of them. You're on holiday, but your mate is like, I've died. Like, oh, enjoy it.
Fucking night.
We have mushrooms, but mushrooms.
We're very easily led people, aren't we?
Yeah.
Someone goes to that, I go, okay, do you know what I mean?
Just got to have a fucking ball in. Like,
if you got the cat out now, I'd be like, go ahead then.
Even though we don't have it.
So when you got back off holiday and all that, then you're together, obviously, because you've sent her a text. What happened then? Obviously, campers in a van or in Nate.
Scouts is in a van.
Look that out. I always call them campers in a van for some reason. But anyway, scouts is in a van and outdoors nature. But obviously, you're in the city at this time, he's together. How the fuck's that get?
Well, no, I were in the city. I was sort of doing campers in a van. Do you know what it is? Scouts in a van didn't even exist. I bought this van probably 4 months before I even met Kennedy, and I had something what I wanted to do myself anyway, because city life is just not for me. And sort of stayed in the van with me. I can remember in the mountains, and she had the big coat of going, well, it's freezing it, so I didn't think she liked it.
Yeah, because we didn't have fucking blankets, we didn't have a mattress. We just had coats.
And it was snowing and everything. Freezing.
So you were out in the van fucking freezing your balls off, and then when Ken comes into the equation, you're getting fucking like restaurant standard food.
The van and I was like, oh, this has got potential. This is right, this is what's going to happen. And then from there, like,
give it a woman's touch.
So I know you were out in the van first, but did Ken make campers, scouts in a van then?
Yeah, she did. I was getting to that just then. Like, so I was sort of like solo. I thought, you know what, I'm going to do this by myself. I had Europe and all that. I thought, no more relationships. I've had toxic relationships all my life, same as Kennedy. Fuck the exes.
You're watching. He probably will.
But yeah, fucking little games.
What a snow.
What a snow.
Drinking in a semi.
Dropping out of a baby in a cemetery. You know what I mean? Fucking hell.
You don't think about using them all.
That phone's held up by a candle now. It was held up by a bottle of Bud on a tombstone before it
shined. Eggs up.
Oh yeah, we was going to do that. One time I go round, egging the exes out. I just remember that.
Yeah. Can't say that.
Yeah, well, it never happened. But yeah, anyway, so sort of like, we started wheeling into the adventure life, getting out there, and then Ken, a first pair of boots, and she was tiptoeing over mud. Like dodging mud in a beach.
But I realised that to get dirty.
Yeah, it's like, a bit of dirt on my boots. I've got bloody candle wax from last night, mate. But a bit of dirt on my boots. I'm trying to clean here, outdoor boots and all that. So I went from there, and then we grew. And then Ken wanted to meet campervan friends, didn't you? And then,
yeah, so obviously, like, I think because, as you know, when you're on phones and stuff, like, whatever you're searching comes up. So because I was getting into this van life, I was searching things like van life stuff, so it started popping up on my Instagram. And I come across like two van life couples on Instagram, and I was like, I want to make an Instagram so we can have these friends, because we go out.
Friends!
So I was thinking, I'd love to have like camper van friends.
Yeah,
community, because there is one. I was like, I want to be part of it. How can you be part of it? Let's make an Instagram. So amazing, and I was like, mate, we've got 20 followers. I was like,
fucking
buzzing.
Like, no,
I was like, oh my god.
We're getting 5 likes. Like, oh my god, 5 likes. Getting all that. We're just
kind of buzzing. And then I was on it for like a few like months, and he wasn't interested in it.
I didn't even go near it.
Yeah.
Hate social media.
Didn't go near it for the first year. And it sort of flipped now. Like, it's like, you know, mix all over it. I'm just like, oh, what should I do here? Like, I didn't know it was going to go this big. Stop it.
I've literally got a beggar to help me with throwing messages. A thing, right, with because I've never really done social media. I have Facebook, but I was never on it, or it was like good night to book and all that shit. Just
good night to book.
It was all that stuff. It was just in bollocks. Like, oh, today I'm going for a chippy scrap. Yeah. All that, yeah, and then she made the Instagram, and then I got my head into it and all that. And now our page has grown so much. We've got so many followers, and we interact with more than half of our followers, which is massive. We get more than half the people watching our stories, which is massive. It's massive, and a big thing with that, my own personal opinion, is because we interact with everyone who messages us to get a message back.
Of course, yeah.
Interact with everyone, and because there's times where I've messaged people and they ignore you, or they read your message and
you
ignore
like it,
you.
And you, so don't do it to someone else.
Yeah, yeah. Ooh, so.
What help you is when you've got 50,000
followers, like, you'll need to impose it. I tell you what, bloody hell. But it's like, that's a big thing to you make a relationship. You make a relationship with your followers, and then you make friends, and you make it. It's this thing now in life where when you was kids, you used to knock at each other's doors, and there was no phones or all that, and you used to be like, are we going out tomorrow? Tomorrow, we meet at 9 o'clock, used to be up dead there. But now it's, you make Instagram friends, and it's not a certain age group as well. It's all different ages, from like 18, to 50-year-old. And you're all like a big community.
We've got like young and old followers. We even had someone today, didn't we? Like, message us, proper dead nice.
49-year-old fella, a proper, oh my god, a lovely message, an inspirational couple, what we are. And
makes you feel like you're a kid again, that like fun thing.
What was the Instagram name for that? What was that?
I can't even remember.
But he's going to Ibiza for this.
He's going to Ibiza. Listen, we'll put the link in it. Yeah, we'll put the link in the description. Right,
yeah, do the fancy thing, like,
there's the link. Bell and the
we don't know how to do that, but we don't know how to do it, but we'll figure out.
There'll be fucking not a name when it comes out.
The bell's over there.
But he was like complimenting. But the thing is, with this Scousers in a Van thing is, it's like this setting your brain, and you're going back to when you was a child, and you take out. And I do understand people got to work, but wait there, no, sorry, you do not have to work.
No.
Do you know what I mean? You don't have to work. Okay, go and work for a year. Yeah. Right, I can't say this word. Minimalize.
Minimalist.
I think I can say it right, but I don't want to.
Minimalize.
Yeah. So
that's the down. That's the down. I know.
So it's literally if you want this life. You minimalize, fucking the little things,
Just fucking say it, like, that's your language.
Minimalize, all your things, in life. Like, you don't need the best clothes, you don't need that best couch, you don't need the best cooker, you don't need all the best things. Take everything away, what you don't need. Yeah. Might sound crazy, but take away your gas bills, you go outdoors, go and buy a cooker. What we've got in here for £100 and a bottle of gas.
I know, we've had it for nearly
£15 probably do, in a house, I'd say a month, so it's £15 gas a month. You're heating, same again, go outdoors, buy a little a gas thingy. I know it sounds a bit extreme, but if you really want to do a life like this, minimalise all the things you don't need, yeah? Save all that money, buy your van, it doesn't have to be an expensive van. Buy your van, you don't have to have anything in, a mattress, a fucking heater, does it until you get more money. Yeah. Work for a year, save your money, do it, and then have money saved up. Now what we could do as soon as our money runs out is, well, Ken could do this, not fucking me.
But she's got what you're gonna say.
I fucking don't know what you what is it?
It was like Ken.
No,
what did she do? I don't want to air this.
No foil thing. Bags or nothing like that. No detail. She go and get a job for 3 months. I can myself, we can both go and get a job for 3 months. You save every penny, because you've got no bills to pay in this life. Just your food. And your diesel.
Well, that's it.
And then you're off.
Well, that's what gets people, I think, even people without knowing these details that you're going to tell everyone about.
Yeah.
I think people just watch your page and think, fucking hell. It automatically gives them a little window, like they can just press that button and watch yous all in Scotland.
Yeah,
yeah. You're there.
Yeah. Feel like you're there.
Yeah. And I know it's caused loads of fucking knobheads to say, what the fuck, how the fuck did you do that? But at the end of the day, this is how you do it, and you'll tell them in a minute. But everyone's like,
I don't want to tell
Ken's
them.
Ken's kitchen is active every single day. Now we filled up that gas, is it, what's it called, a gas thingy?
Gas thingy.
£15, and it lasts us a year. We've just went and topped it up now, so.
No, that was the last one. When we weren't doing it as much as what we was doing, it lasted like a year, The last one what we bought for Scotland, it lasted as probably 2 months.
It's fucking last ages, fucking hell.
2 months.
Bobbins, pennies.
Pennies. Or just
I don't understand how it's that cheap, to be honest.
People think it's dead expensive to like do all this, but it's not. It's just getting over that fear of like, listen, realising you don't have to just be in that system and that. You can literally,
what
are you for? So people sort of think that they can't sort of get into this sort of lifestyle because it's too much sort of money or anything like that, but as you say, it's not expensive whatsoever. I think it's people being afraid to sort of let go of responsibilities and stuff like that.
Take losing everything you've worked on and stuff, like whether it be your career or
just all things. People got things like you've got a couch, it's a thing. You've got a big massive telly, it's a thing. When you've got a big telly, you want a bigger telly. When you've got a big couch, you want a bigger couch. You always want something more. You need to cut that.
It's like being
shit that out. Yeah.
It's like being caught up in the system, isn't it? Course, university and college, and you think, well, I've worked that hard to get this degree. I need to be in the city to think you. But I think that, you know, if you don't sort of see that how good it is to be out in the wild, then you're not ready for it, are you? If you don't feel the urge to do it, you're not ready.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, that's all we need. We need the wild. That's all we are. Our souls are more.
Course. It's where we come from. It's where we come from. I couldn't go back to city life, me.
No.
Not happening.
Yeah.
Not happening.
What am I? Don't miss it.
No. Don't miss it. I obviously miss family and all, but I don't miss family because I see family and I speak to family all the time.
Of course.
When we're at home, I don't think about, oh, let's go to town or let's do like city things. I think about seeing the family and stuff and just spending time with people.
I sit there rocking like, when are we going?
you don't do well with it, do you, in the city life? But that's because
that one way.
You got into this lifestyle for a specific reason, lad, and also. So what's that reason? Because obviously it's helping you with a certain something and you've told me about it, but...
My mental health, I suffer bad with mental health and all that, and shall I tell my story, what happened and stuff like
that? Yeah, tell your story,
wait, definitely cut all that out.
You're
I don't know where I was going, I was getting all emotional, and I was I was like, I didn't even know what I was talking about there.
If you're going to hesitate in that, lad, you
stop, I'm a baby, stop.
I was like, fucking talking about people, it's nothing to do with people.
I know, I've heard this story a lot of times, I was like,
I've never mentioned people, have I? Never mentioned people.
It's a lovely place.
I love it, baby. Fucking hell, going on about just getting stabbed and people, that's it, it's nothing to do with people. I suffer with mental health, not a lot of people know this, not a lot of people will believe this either, because I'm always dead happy, all over camera, like, hey, look at me and Ken, dead happy and all that. But nature is my cure for anyone with mental health, nature's the cure. And I know a lot of people know this, just go for a walk around the park, go for a walk around the fucking cemetery, wherever you're going to go for a walk, my mental health is not drug related, it's not alcohol related, believe it or not.
Cheers to that.
Not like that. I don't do drugs and all, I don't do coke. I have done in the past, like in my younger 20s, but don't do all that bollocks, it's just... mine's through trauma. I think I suffer with PTSD, so I was on a night out with my brother. I don't do drugs and all that, but I was off my tits on cocaine, yeah. No, it was.
Just real.
Yeah, to draw. I'm not embarrassed about my past.
That truth is our truth.
Yeah, it's right. So me brother, our poor, been on a mad one, 2 days no sleep, went to town, cocaine and all that, went to town. Don't even ask what happened, because I don't know, can't remember. I got the absolute shit kicked out of me. Apparently, I tipped over my feet. This is from the police. Tipped over my feet and knocked myself out. I got battered inside the club at first, and then I tipped over my feet, knocked myself out after trying to shake the lad's hand who'd done it. Being knocked out, the lads ran over to me, looked at me, snoring, and then he just went to work on me. I've got all metal all down my face here. I've got a big metal plate here. I've got wires holding my jaw, a splint here holding my bottom teeth. I've got all metal down my eye socket. Doctor said if you get hit there again, you'll have a deformity. That made me terrified of people years down the line. Didn't think nothing of it. I had all,
I remember that,
this is, I was like that for months.
Yeah, I remember that.
I had to drink through a straw, as people say, but I couldn't even drink through a straw. I had to mush it. Remember one time, my mum done a roast for everyone, and I was like, oh, dead hungry, you lost loads of weight. So I look sick, man, six pack and everything.
But
my mum done a roast, and I was like, oh, she's seen in my face. So what my mum done, she got it, what are they called? Sorry, my brain's gone.
A whizzer?
Yeah, a whizzer.
A blend.
A whizzer.
So on the vegan diet then.
So what she done, she whizzed the roast that night. She dingied it down for me. No, she did, yeah. And I had that. It was the best thing I've ever had. Tomato sauce, everything in it.
Yes.
Boss, so we had them like all the time.
Oh, I feel so sorry for you.
No, it was lovely. It was boss. I highly recommend that as well. But, the face smashed in. So, yeah, so that didn't really affect me. I didn't learn my lesson. And then a few years, I was still drinking cocaine. Mixing with cocaine-drinking people, yeah. And then I was with my mate, Ryan. Yeah, and I was in his. Ryan ordered some cocaine off some lad, I don't know what happened, but the lad was busy, he got off someone else, and then this lad rang Ryan, he said he's not busy no more, started trying to bully me, mate, I'm like, behave yourself, blah blah blah. So he come round with his uncle, again being on a 2-dayer with Ryan, couldn't even see, 4:30 in the daytime, I'm walking home. No. Next thing, he's arguing with me with his uncle, couldn't even stand up, I'm like, oh, behave, walked away from behind, popped me, stabbed me right here. I thought I was going to die. As mad as this sounds, the film Gladiator, if you've ever seen that, at the very end where he gets stabbed.
Seen it.
And he dies, but that was going through my head. It's crazy, that, isn't it? Yeah, like, not my family or not, and it was going in my head. I was like, shit. But I was in hospital, I had tubes coming out of me, I had to have a cataract and all. It was bad, really bad. And after that, I sort of, woke up. I weren't affected still by, I weren't stressed, depressed, nothing. A few years went on again. These attacks, by the way, was 3 years in each other. So carried on with me normal things and all that. Weren't affected, weren't scared. And then 4 years after, hit me. And I was
PTSD,
like, scared of people, scared of cities, just terrified.
Yeah.
Terrified to go out, my house, anywhere. And sort of had a big fucking...
big like sort of influence on you.
Yeah, man, I'm getting.
It's all right.
I've never spoken about this.
It's all right, brother.
Oh.
And so it.
I've never spoken about it, man. You see, so.
Yeah, it's all right.
And
it's hard.
It's good. It's getting it out, isn't it?
It is. Listen, any of that sort of stuff.
It's losing, it's fucking, it's power on you, you're letting it out.
Give us a man cuddle, lad.
I knew this shit
would
happen, man.
Oh!
It's alright, brother.
I knew this shit would happen, man.
It's so funny, lad. It's understandable, mate, it's hard. All that stuff.
I've never actually, I've never ever talked about any of my mental health, mate. So,
well, that's
all that, but
listen, it's big. I didn't know about this. I might have knew about it at one point, but I didn't.
Yeah,
what they call the stabbing one, it's absolutely like, that's a big, massive thing. And obviously you said that they were both in 3 years apart, lad. It's big, and it's no way, just nothing shameful about getting upset about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, it's not even the people who've done it. I mean, if anything, look, if you watch it, I thank yous every day, because I would not be here living the life I'm living. I would not be in a campfire, I wouldn't have a gorgeous bed. I wouldn't, both of us wouldn't be inspiring all these people who we are, do you know what I mean? So, I thank you from the bottom of my heart, and you forgive. I'm not even bothered about that. That's just young people do that shit when they're young, do you know what I mean? It's testosterone and all that. I'm not bothered about them people.
It's all part of your story, and it's what's brought you here right now, isn't it?
This mental health stuff, it's, people see me on camera and they're like, wow, I'm dead happy. Yeah. But it's nature. What does that to me? And then, I decided I don't want city life no more. Shut myself away from everyone, and the camper van life. I want to do it, and it just so happens I met a gorgeous girl who wants to do. Yeah, it's okay, babe.
So he's up the ass.
He's back. Yeah, it's awful like that, because I believe, and you might be the same, but it's your soul's at home when you're outdoors. That's the true riches in life, isn't it?
Yeah.
No designer pair of chainies or anything is going to get you over that experience.
No, it's
it. See the power of outdoors and nature. Yeah. That's the true wealth, isn't it? That can buy freedom.
Yeah,
and you're free from that when you're out there.
Well, it's still there. It's there when I go to sleep. It's there when I wake up. It's there now. I can feel it. It's always there. And I've been told by a lot of people I know you're there. Thank you. But nah, not today. But it's hard. It's hard to take control of it. But when I'm out in nature, mate, it's, people say, oh, you're hiding behind a smile and that. Like, not in the nice way, like, oh, yeah, I get you're hiding behind the smile. Not hiding behind a smile in nature. I am living, walking proof. Nature is the cure to anyone with any mental health, anything. Nature is, just look at me. Look, the difference when I'm out there to when I'm home, it's crazy, isn't it?
Yeah.
But when I come back home, or any city, it's not just Liverpool, any city, I'm hiding behind a smile then. That's when I am hiding behind. Nature, gone, everything's gone. The city, I'm like, yeah, I'm hiding, but I'm scared to go out and all that. And I love the dark, mate, because it hides me, it hides my eyes and all that. And sunglasses.
Can you pass my sunglasses to
us? Oh, yeah. So my sunglasses, which a lot of people know, they're broke now, and I couldn't give a fuck. But this is my mask. This hides me, Even though I look like an absolute maniac.
But it does something.
For my anxiety, it makes me feel invisible. And that, not just these sunglasses, any sunglasses, powerful for me. I was going to say, you never see me with my sunglasses off and all that.
When you're in nature, when you're outdoors, do you wear them?
No. Don't exist.
There we go.
Don't exist, do you?
That's
unless
powerful.
It's really sunny.
But yeah, that's like my thing. My sunglasses. It could be snowing. I could be on top of a mountain with a big coat on, wearing my sunglasses, look like an absolute tip. But it makes me feel safe. Do you know what I mean? And that helps me with my mental health, doesn't it?
Yeah, going to home and bargain with them on and stuff.
I look like a twat. And then out there,
they're like bright blue purple as well, so it looks like he's going skiing while he's getting his bed.
But yeah, it's boss. It helps me with my mental health. And as I was saying before, I know a lot of people don't understand. Like, they see me and Ken all happy and all this and all that, and they think, they haven't got no mental health, they haven't got no problems. But yeah, we have. Yeah. Everyone's got problems, I get that, but as I said before, nature is the cure, man. Yeah. Plus microdosing, but your next podcast
with
Carlos.
Recycled souls will fucking go into detail.
That's
his
area, do you know what I mean?
Although we've got mushrooms there, gives one off fucking problem. But so nature, and I'm longing to go into nature all the time. That's what I know it when I'm I am more at home and feel more peaceful. And it's the same as what you were saying, when I get a camp chair down in the middle of the countryside or Wales, Scotland, wherever, and I'm just like that. And it's because our souls are home. Do you know what I mean?
It's come from, innit?
That's it. What was your thing, Ken, about nature? Was you a camper? Was you an outdoor?
Now I love the idea of it. Like I like the thought of like, oh, I just want to get dirty and just like, you know, go wild. No, like, get me a nice pair of shoes and stuff like that. I don't want to get dirty. But I love the idea of like going wild, and I think it's because I never knew it. I never went outdoors. I didn't even know what a mountain looked like. Well, I did. I've been to like, you know, Switzerland and stuff, but I didn't know what it was like to climb a mountain. I used to think like, are you like this, climbing like, you know, like Snowdonia or something like.
A lot of people think that, don't they? We get a lot of messages like that.
Yeah. And like, he brought me to Wales for the first time. I was like, oh, there's a sheep. Look at all them sheep. Like that video and stuff like that. No, I'm like, oh yeah. Just like, sometimes as well, I need to realise, because I'm seeing it so much, sometimes I pinch myself and like, Kennedy, like, appreciate it. I appreciate it more, like, so much. Yeah. But, like, from, like, 3 years ago, I was like, wow, look at this. And because I'm so used to it and stuff, I need to, like, you know, really
take a step back,
and go, like, sometimes wow,
That's, like, a thing in life, isn't it?
Yeah.
Sometimes you've just got to appreciate what you've got and what you've got around you.
Because we're just living this life just so, like, so freely and stuff.
Definitely.
Can I just say like, a lot of people, to this life that we were talking about it before, I forgot to mention it. A lot of people see you on a full-time holiday, probably an all-inclusive full-time holiday, don't you? So a lot of people, they ask, I shouldn't really give this trick away, like, but you know, everyone should live this life.
Fucking hell, give it away, let's
do it. It's not a trick, it's just, it's very simple. Like I was saying before, the minimalist thing, all that, but people say like, how can you afford van life? So
it's cheap as fuck.
Yeah, of course. So I mean, I understand why people ask that question, because
I think you have got to start off in a way. You've got to have the money to start off, but once you've got it,
obviously you've got to
keep it up with it. It's sad, but you've got to put the graft in at first when it's here.
Obviously all that, but I mean like, people see us in the mountains and at a waterfall and at this amazing lake and then. It's free.
It's fucking free.
It's free. It doesn't cost one penny.
That's a shout.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
I knew that. Yeah. The way you said it then.
Everyone knows it. You all know it. Everyone knows it. Everyone. But you just don't want to take that leap. Now what Ken's saying there, you've obviously got to get the graph for your van, for this, for that. But then when you've done that, that's the hard part, which isn't very hard. Just take the minimalist shit, all that, and then
could be in the dictionary soon, your version of that, I swear.
Just go sit in a van, make a minimalist. But should be an MC, should name a minimalist. But but it's like, so I say this to a few people, so let's say we're driving from Liverpool in a van, right, and we're going to the Lake District, we're going there for a month, okay, so let's put £20 petrol in it, we'll go there. We are park up. So your rent for a whole month is £20. For a month. The shops, so where we go, you can go a lot of places, you can go right out there in the sticks. If you do that, you're gonna have to spend your month's food, which in a van probably cost us £40 a week,
Got this fridge here that fills up.
We've got the solar panel, split charge, solar panel keeps all the electrics on and that. The heating's a diesel heater, which is going in. Tom, escape room versions, put his name here. he's sorting that out next week.
Find the link there.
he's sorting that out next
Anyone
week.
Anyone who
But it's all these things, you're not paying electricity, you're not paying gas for your heating. You're paying your £15 for 2 months little stove and your diesel, you just fill that up, it probably last you 2 months or won't it? All these things are free, so let's say an average person who's working with a flat or a mortgage, you've got your car and all that, let's say £2,000 a month, that's all your food, all your bills, everything all in, £2,000 a month. Now I want you to half that, half that again, taking on an underdog, what do you reckon? And it's for two people, £400 a month, easy, does us, but then, we all know we like a drink, me and Ken. So that does up our budget, you know what I mean? A lot of people like smoking weed, a lot of people like doing different things. So then you put your own budget on top of your 400, so let's say...
At first
550 a month, yeah. Sorry. 550 a month. So let's do 550 a month, let's do 10 months, which is 5,500, add another 2 months on that, so 5...
Just pause the video and work it out, get back to us.
Yeah. Like 7 grand a year. Let's just go all out, say 10 grand a year and you're living. You know what
that's
I mean?
It. Fat. But...
Very cheap.
Let me tell you though, obviously, you have come at it from different... Ken, did you ever have any sort of mental health issues or anything like that? That nature has helped you with, or has it just made you happier in general?
Not particularly, but when I was growing up, I didn't know what I wanted. I didn't know what I felt like, quite lost. But I was just like, yeah. I don't know what I want to do in life. And as I was getting older, I was like, I don't want to. I want to work, but I don't. I want to. I just want to travel. I was like, how can you just be free and just travel, but like you know, be able to live as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry, I'm a bit scared there.
Don't mind us.
Yeah, so all I wanted to do was, I knew straight away, all I wanted to do was travel. And my mum passed away a few years ago, and she was saying to me, Kennedy, like, life is so short. She knew how much I loved, like, going on a holiday. Like, I'd save up, every bit of my money was just to go, like, places. I've got family in Switzerland, so I go there 3 times a year.
Yeah.
Just travelling and going places as much as I could. Mm. And she just said, Kennedy, just keep going, just keep exploring the world as much as you can. Like, life is too short. So I was like, that was in my head. I was like, I need to appreciate life. Life is too short. I'm going to do it for my mum. I'm going to travel as much as I can. And I didn't know I was going to... I'd met him, literally.
Him has a name.
I actually met him. It was so weird. I met him about a week or two before my mum passed. He didn't know nothing about it because we were just fresh, just new.
I've heard all about Kelly, like, I'm gutted that I never met her.
Yeah.
I'm with dad and a family. I'm sorry.
It's alright. But it's sort of weird in a way.
Like,
I don't know whether like it was sort of. I don't know whether it happens sort of by coincidence, but then Mick just coming to me like
she manifested it. Telling the story about manifesting.
I've done nothing but adventure since. So like from my mum saying that, and then literally from there, just meeting you and just
telling the story about manifesting me.
For good stuff.
What? Telling the story about manifesting me. You manifested
them. I manifested them, I swear to God. Like,
I manifested them.
You can't say
all well.
Girls and sit there and I go, right, what's your dream, man? What do you want? And I literally sat down to, like, I want him to have scars. He's got scars. I want him to be, like, tall but not, like, lanky. I want him to be, like, big but not, like, muscly or, you know.
A good fucking slab of meat.
Yeah! I want him to be, yeah!
Manifested a good slab
of
meat.
I said, I don't want muscles, but I want him to be big. I want him
to be big. I've got bitch
tits, you know what I mean? And he's a... I love his bitch tits, honestly.
We have a boob off.
We have a boob off all the time.
She always wins, though. His nipples are bigger than mine.
But honestly, it's weird that I did it for her, like... I even said I didn't want him to have social media because I hate people that like.
And I never had social media.
Look at you fucking now.
But now I used to think that's possible. But now I'm seeing it from different ways where it can help people and stuff.
Oh,
like
okay.
We wouldn't be here now if it weren't for it and stuff.
Oh, yeah, it's
and
positive.
All the things we've been gifted, is that what it's called? Like people have like, you know, given.
Gifted? Hashtag gifted.
No, I mean like because of social media and not sharing our life, like people have.
People approach us.
Yeah. So about opportunities, like this is an opportunity because of social media. So
yeah, of course. Showing people an alternative way of life, and we get these big companies. A year ago, I was 2.5 years. As well, me and Ken's been doing this 2.5 years. Yeah, social media's been up just over a year now. Yeah, just over a year, and 2.5 fucking years. Why didn't you do Scout Cinema 2.5 years ago? We'd be on 20,000. Okay.
So listen, podcast 2 years ago. I mean, sorry. Cut. Scouts is in a van 2 years ago. Listen, everything's just for a certain path, mate, and it just all comes together.
Yeah, it is. Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
But we have been doing this for 2.5 years. We've been saying 2.5 years for the last 6 months, haven't we?
Yeah.
We've been doing this for 3 years. How long have we been with each other for? What date did you get with me? What time?
We met at the 3rd of June.
3rd of June? Mm. what date is it now?
You didn't make me a girlfriend until like September.
August, September.
We're bonding then.
Okay, so we're going on 3 years. We're going on 3 years. We've been doing this 3 years, so the social media's been up just over a year. So, alright, yeah, fuck off, it is 2.5 years. 2.5 years before social media, is that right? Sorry, the bottles went to my head, so just ignore me.
Yeah, exactly 2.5 years.
Well, listen, do you want to tell you something? Do you know what? As you've said before about the mental health and all that sort of stuff, not many people would have knew about it because in life we've got to deal with our mental health internally and get it out there to get to the point where we're happy and fucking and just having a good fucking time in life, you know what I mean? And that's what yous, I think, are a fucking proper, like, use the image of that. Yous absolutely just have the ball. Your sense of humour and your fucking fun is... second to none. But that's why a lot of people are drawn to you, but then also why them same people will be like, oh my god, I knew they were having a fucking boss time and I wanted to be like that.
Yeah.
But now they've also got like the bad days as well.
The
that I have.
Yeah.
Do you know what, so that'll give them the inspiration to do it themselves.
Yeah, everyone's human, aren't they?
That's it, of course. But anyway, so for all them people. We've seen the mental health, now we're going to get into the fun bits.
Yeah.
Woo! Let's fucking eat some bugs, motherfuckers.
can I just say, before these bugs, I'm just trying to get more time, when it's like, me speaking about my mental health, it's like, it is really a big thing. I've never spoken about it, I haven't really spoken about it properly on this podcast. I have spoken about it on this podcast, I feel like I need to release, do you know what I mean? Because I felt good after that, yeah? So, if that little bit of mental health reaches just one man or woman, yeah, with mental health, it's a win. Because men, I'm not being sexist, but men, especially because it's a big dominant thing, they're scared to speak about the mental health. So, me speaking about it, just if it reaches people, just talk about your mental health, because those men, motherfuckers,
aren't they? When I first met him, I can't see you being anything other than like happy, because he was always constantly happy all the time.
Because I am.
Sometimes, I even said, like, you know, do you know Robin Williams?
I was speaking about him today with Carlos.
Yeah.
It's just crazy, isn't it? Sometimes it's, you know, the people that you don't expect. And you never know. The hardest to make people laugh or try and, you know, make people happy. They're the ones that are hiding it and bottling it up.
I think it's the people with like a gift. Everyone's got a gift in their own way, but the people that show their light, when you are able to reach within yourself to have the power to show your light and not be ashamed of that.
Yeah.
It comes a responsibility, not a responsibility, but a little bit of a downfall with it, because when you're on a high frequency,
you're gonna have low frequencies to come with it.
We've been sent here now, right? I know a lot of people, all that universe and all that, me and Ken are light workers, all of our spiritual friends, love yous all by the way, all the tribe, me and Ken didn't know this before, that they all told us this. I'm trying to get away from the bugs, you see.
You're the one that leaked them.
I know. No, but all of our spiritual brothers and all our spiritual sisters, who we've met, oh boss man, I wish I knew them years ago. We've all been through shit. We've all been had our problems, and now we're all together. Surround yourself around people who lift you all the time. All the time. If you've got a negative thing, just go away from them, or tell that person you're negative. Nah, not happening with me, Tony. But I was going to say, me and Ken, we always claim we're not spiritual, do you know what I mean? Like, a lot of our spiritual friends talk about stuff we don't know, like crystals. I don't understand crystals, even though I've got me tiger's eye, do you know what I mean? And this is powerful to me, it protects me.
But
we don't understand crystals, do we? Chakras and...
We're open to it, when we heard about it, even though we're confused by some things, we're very open to it, because we always, both of us, if you haven't talked for yourself, feel like we didn't fit into maybe friendship groups we've been in. Because I've been in ones where it's bitchy, it's like, oh, look at the state of air, look at that, and I've been like, oh, why can't we just all be happy and stuff?
Well, that's true, spiritually.
Because I feel like we've always have been, like, in our heads.
Well, this is what they say, a lot of them say...
I think you try to be a nice person, like,
Well, we're light workers, like yourself, you're a light worker. A light worker is
help people.
We shine our positivity, we shine our light.
Any type of form.
So if
you're vulnerable as well to the effects of giving so much, aren't
you? Yeah. So
I find
like a lot of people sometimes won't, a lot of people be watching who are watching this are probably like, what the fuck's he talking about? Because they don't get it. Me a year ago, I'd be like, what's he talking about? But it's boss man, isn't it? Like, I'm sorry, I don't know where I'm going here.
You're trying to distract yourself from these
books, spiritual motherfuckers.
I'm just trying to say, these spiritual people sounds racist now, doesn't it? These people. Mm-hmm. People. But no, just say, they always tell us we're light workers, they always surround yourself by people who lift you and all that, and it's fucking true, isn't it? Mm-hmm. It's the universe gives you. This is what I mean, where I'm going with it. I just think people be laughing. He's out of the bed, but the universe gives you shit, man. It really does. I promise you, it's so true. The law of attraction, all this. Don't need to get into all that, but it's so
true, man. You've got to sort of realise you're a part of it. You're not sort of not putting people down, but no one's nothing special. Everyone's a part of this. Yeah. Consciousness, and if you do the right things, you are gifted and rewarded for that terms of happiness and true balance.
We're all connected, and I know I'm not even going into this. Leave this to Carlos and all that, but we're all connected, man.
Yeah.
We really fucking are, and a lot of people don't get that. A lot of people who be watching this don't get that, but you will have your awakening. Who's watching this now thinking I'm a crackpot, you will have your awakening. Everyone has it, do you know what I mean? And let's get on to the bugs.
So now,
Ken,
let's
go fucking
live on that.
Yeah.
So, we're doing a podcast with Just Real. And here's our little setup. You can't see because it's pitch black. And we're doing a bit of a bush tucker trial.
And here's the police. Look, here's the police. That'll be fine, it'll be fine now. But we're not gonna tell them we're eating bugs. We know it's Halloween.
Right, so basically we're doing a podcast, we're in the middle of it. This is the second part. And we're doing a little bush tucker trial. We've got some crickets, we've got some mealworms, we've got some. I'll just show you this for it. Vegans, look away now.
Vegans.
Right.
I'm with them all day anyway.
Ooh, you want to see Mick eating one of these? The busies are here, so we're just going to wait for a minute.
All right, officer. Okay.
About to do a bush tucker trial. He's had a Mackey's.
Are you sure you don't want one of these? I've had a Mackey's.
Yeah. Fucking wet.
I've had a Mackey's. Right, so we're just going to get straight to it. No fucking about.
So this way, mate. You can eat that first.
Right, so they've got Joe. Mick.
Hey, what about this bad boy? Who's eating that?
Fuck it.
Let's see what you want.
That's it, yeah.
He's eating a worm. Are you eating the glossus? Oh my god, no!
My new diet.
a leg stuck in your tooth. He's got a leg stuck in his tooth.
No one likes this, you know, just turn the camera off. I'm starving.
Everyone's all getting pissed for Halloween and, you know, the blue moon and all that.
Oh, do you want to see the head on this?
We're sat in the cemetery with
chicken. That sounds wrong. Your dad's on that. What's wrong there? Laughing, are you not?